Hi, my name is Erin Blau, and I'm a nurse practitioner and EIS officer with the CDC, assigned to the Kentucky Department for Public Health. This past fall of 2018, we began investigating a vaccination-associated infections outbreak in Kentucky and surrounding areas, including Indiana and Ohio. This outbreak was really revealing and allowed us to look into the risk for healthcare-associated infections when vaccinations aren't stored or handled properly. And through our investigation, we uncovered over 100 individuals who experienced Mycobacterium fortuitum infections and reactions at their injection site as a result of this. We estimate over 1,000 individuals received vaccinations from this business during this time frame, and we worked with our local health departments and our community physicians to reach out to these individuals so they sought appropriate medical treatment. We notified community providers of these infections in the community so that they were able to reach out to their patients and test appropriately for this bacteria, as it's not something that's routinely screened for. The biggest takeaway I would say for infectious disease providers is to really be screening for this if there is a concern. Given the prolonged duration or incubation period for these infections. So these individuals were experiencing infections weeks after administration of the vaccine, given the longer incubation period for Mycobacterium fortuitum, which was the bacteria that we isolated as part of this outbreak. It was also really important to work closely with our providers in the community, as they were actually the first ones to identify this outbreak and reach out to the health department to notify us. And that's just a huge relationship and one to build moving forward so that we are able to work hand in hand on outbreak investigations like this. I think it's really important to recognize that this is the exception, that this isn't something that happens routinely, and that as long as providers are following routine recommendations provided by the CDC and through their vaccinations and the insert packets, that they're able to follow those storage and handling procedures, that this should be avoided in the future, and that this is really an exception and an example of what might occur when someone isn't handling vaccine appropriately in this setting.